Alright, so let's try this problem. It asks for the internal shear force and bending moment passing through point C. The first thing you'll probably notice compared to the problem we previously worked is that point C is right underneath the force. It's going to be hard to determine what the shear force is right underneath a point load. So we're going to do a little kind of a little trick is we're going to look just to the left of C and just to the right of C. And just to means as close as I can get to C from the left to right and not be at C. Okay? So I'll show you how that works. Now if I cut the structure, say right here at C, let's look at the left side. If I want to work the left side, what do I need to know? I need to get find the reactions at A. Okay, that takes some work. What if I work the right side? What do I need to know? No reactions, because it's cantilever. So I think there's a clear choice here that when we make our cut at C, either just to the left or just to the right, that we work the right-hand side. It's less work. You guys see that? So let's start. Oops. I was attached to the floor. So let's look at a cut just to the left of C. So that means I'll make my cut just here to the left. So when I draw my free body diagram for that, since I'm cutting just to the left of C, I will include the 500-pound force at C. And then I'll have the 500-pound force at D. And then out here on the cantilever at point E, I'll also have my 500-pound force. And then there's an applied moment at the end of 2,000 pound feet. And this distance will be 10 feet and 10 feet.
So let me to the right. Is it to the right or to the left?
This is to the left, so I'm making my cut to the left of C.
Oh, okay. So to the right.
And then the next one I'll do is I'll go just to the right of C. And we'll see what the difference is. So now on this internal surface, I will assume positive axial force, right? See how that's tension? What's positive shear force? Is it going to be up or down? It's going to be up. Remember, positive shear force tends to make the section rotate clockwise. See how it would make it rotate clockwise? And then positive bending moment looks like that. See that? Positive shear force, tension, positive, I'm sorry, axial force, tension, positive shear force, positive bending moment. So I'm just going to write my equations of equilibrium and solve for that. So just like we talked about before, I'm going to sum moments first at the cut. And make sure the whole structure is in equilibrium. I'm going to use right-hand rule for my sign. Starting at the cut, using right-hand rule, what kind of moment is this? Positive or negative?
Negative.
It's negative. What's the moment produced by this 500-pound force about the cut?
Zero.
Zero. Has no moment on, right. Very, 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 very small. But these two 500-pound forces create what kind of moment? Negative, right? I'm going to go ahead and convert those to kips. So that'll be half a kip. And then the distance is 10 feet. And the second one is also 500 pounds or half a kip. And the moment arm is 20 feet. And then I have the applied moment out here at the end. What kind of moment is that with my sign convention? Positive or negative?
Negative.
That would be 2 kip feet. So I should be able to solve for the moment That looks like 5 plus 10 plus 2, negative 17. Kippy. So what does the negative mean? What kind of thinking moment do I have at just to the left of C?
Frowny face.
What?
Frowny face.
Yeah, frowny face, which is negative bending moment. And how does a structure bend when it's negative? Well, how do you think this is going to bend? What's going to come out of this thing and probably look something like that. So you can see, it's kind of half a frown. And everywhere on there, it's part of a frown. So you would probably expect that the bending moment throughout this entire structure is going to be negative. And right now, it's negative, so that seems to do pretty good. I like that. Since we're here, let's go ahead and get our shear force and axial force. So to get shear force, we'll sum forces in the y direction and make sure that's in equilibrium. I'll assume up is positive. So this shear force is up. And I've got 1, 2, 3 half kip forces acting down. The first one, there's the second, and there's the third. So what's the shear force equal to? Looks like 1.5. And it came out positive, so we have a positive shear force just to the left of C. What's the axial force? It's zero, right? Just to be sure, I'll sum forces in the x direction, make sure it's in equilibrium, and all we have is minus the axial force. So in this, for this loading case, we have no axial force. Any questions about that? So just to emphasize, this is just to the left of C. So we probably should look at just to the right. Let's see. So my free body diagram is going to look pretty much the same. Oops, got my folder later. Except what's true? I'm just to the right of C, so this 500-pound force at C is not there. But I still have my 500-pound force at D. I still have my 500-pound force out at E. I still have my applied bending moment at the end, 2 kips per foot, or 2 kip feet. This is still 10 and 10. So the only difference here is that when I was just to the left, I included the force at C. When I'm just to the right, I do not. Then I'll assume again, positive axial force, positive shear force, positive bending moment. So I'm going to start adding little plus signs to remind you that those are the positive sign conditions. Then I just check to make sure it's in equilibrium. So just like before, I am going to sum the moments at the cut. And what happens? Well, this is still a negative moment. I still have to worry about the moment by these two 500-pound forces, and they're going to create negative moment. So I'll have minus half a kip at 10 feet, minus half a kip at 20 feet, and then out here on the end, my applied moment of 2 kips, of 2 kip feet. So what's the moment? Minus 17. So it looks like the moment is unaffected as I go from the left side to the right side and pass underneath, let's say, or pass by an applied load. There's no sudden change in the moment. Okay? Let's see what happens with our shear force. So now I'll sum forces in the y direction. Let's see what I've got. So I've got the shear force acting up. Got 1, 2 half kip forces acting down. So it looks like the shear now is 1 kip. So the shear to the left of Z is 1.5 kips. And then as I pass underneath, it drops down to 1 kip. So it looks like the change in shear is equal to what? The applied force P, in this case 500 pounds. Notice the quantity is 500, and that's the difference between these two. Now that's just an observation right now. I'm not going to prove that to you, but I will tell you that later we will prove it, and it is valid. So when you pass underneath a point load from left to right, moving from left to right is positive x, right? You'll see your shear instantaneously change value. So it's really hard to say what the value of the shear is at C, because just to the left it's 1.5 and just to the right it's 1. Which of those values is more important? Probably the larger of the two, the 1.5. See that? And you'll notice the change in the moment. Well, there's no change in the moment when you go underneath the load. There's no instantaneous change. So it would look something like this if I were to plot it. So if I were to plot the shear as a function of x, and let's just go ahead and enter. There's where my point C is. So what that would mean is that the shear to the left of C, I don't know what shape it would be, but it would be 1.5 kips. And then just to the right, it would be 1 kip. So you'd see this step change. And again, you can see that the change in shear is equal to the value of the load. And it changes negative, it goes down, right? Because this load is down, and that's a negative load. We're going to assume positive is up, just like we did here for our forces. So loads that act up are positive loads. Loads that act down are negative loads. You guys see that? I kind of didn't give you much space to see it. There it is. We can't really see it. Sorry about that. It kind of got lost there at the bottom. Questions about this one? We're going to work a bunch more. So if you're not quite sure, we'll see as we move forward.